Alrighty, today we're going to be taking a look at a pressure switch, specifically from the Boshart brand. This is my particular favorite type of pressure switch, as I think it's the most reliable. It also comes out of the box looking nice and pretty. I have had very, very little issues with this particular brand of pressure switch. Now, what is a pressure switch, you may be asking? So on a well system, you're going to see one of these little fellas right over here. The whole goal of the pressure switch is to make it where the pump turns on and the pump turns off. So what will happen is you're actually going to have a water stem or nipple into here that will actually push water up and into that hole. In that hole, we're actually going to have a spring that will read that pressure, and it will determine when to turn the pump on and when to turn the pump off. Now, generally, in our area, you'll see that new pressure switch installs will be 40-60 PSI. What that means is, at 40 PSI, the pump kicks on. At 60 PSI, the pump kicks off. That's what we refer to as the cycle length. Generally, you'll have a 20-point swing before the cut on and the cut off. Now, 40-60 is generally used in our area so that we can get a higher pressure rating throughout the home with a little bit less issues total. I generally discourage people from going to 50-70, as you do run the risk of either the pressure relief valve going off or bad joints on the piping going out on you and having a leak. Generally, on older systems with an old jet pump, you'll see that they'll go between 20-40 PSI and then somewhere in between the 60s to now, and even still now on new installs, sometimes you'll see 30-50 PSI. So what do we got going on over here? So we're going to have the holes where the electric wire comes in, right? We're going to have our grounding connections right there. Then we're going to have our placements for the electric wires to come in to the basically connect the house power to the pump power. So how this works, these little contact plates right back here are controlled by this spring right back here. So remember, we got the water that comes up through here, and it's going to push on these plates and the spring. This spring is going to be calibrated to basically connect the contact plates when it's below 40 PSI, and then when it's when it's at 60 PSI, it will disconnect just like this. You'll hear an audible click sound just like that. This little fella is going to be our differential. So remember how I said it's a 20-point swing between cut on and cut off? This is how you adjust that. You can go up a little bit, you can go down a little bit. I don't recommend messing with this. I generally would just leave this where it is. This one in the middle is how you're going to adjust the PSI and the pipes. By turning it clockwise, you will increase the pressure. Turning it counterclockwise will decrease the pressure. Generally, one full rotation will take you about 2 or 3 PSI up, or one full rotation the other direction will take you 2 to 3 PSI the other direction. Really, the easiest way to test this is to get it all wired in, plumbed in, and then while the power is off, make the adjustment, turn the power back on, see what this pressure switch cycles at, turn it off again, and keep adjusting until you eventually get it to wherever you want it to go. Right out of the box, this is the most reliable brand that I've come across. They will almost always be perfectly set to 40-60. Every now and again, you have to make a minor adjustment. But if you're looking for a brand, if you're not sure what to get, Boshart is my favorite. You can see that the box is nice and clean. It'll tell you a little bit more about the emergency and the warnings and stuff on the back. Most of the other brands don't do that. There are a couple electronic pressure switches that exist out there. I do not recommend them. They're a lot more temperamental, and they tend to give the homeowners a little bit more trouble than they're worth. This is an analog pressure switch, so it all just works off the spring in the back. It's more reliable. They're fairly inexpensive, so if you do run into an issue with yours, any guy in the area who does plumbing or well work should be able to swap that out for you with little to no issues. If you like content like this, I have more posted daily on the world of well and septic. Please go ahead, give me a like and subscribe. And if you have any questions or if you want me to address a specific topic, please feel free to leave a comment below and I will respond to everybody that comments. And if you have a specific topic that you want me to cover, I will do my best to get a video put up for you to try and answer whatever question you might have. Till next time.